giving you an opportunity to get the full story from the people who tell it best. This is Mediacom News Leaders.
And welcome to Mediacom News Leaders. Thanks for tuning in. I'm Carol Kelly. Joining us today from the Zach Johnson Foundation, we've got Greg White. Greg, welcome.
Thank you so much for having me today.
So anyone living in Cedar Rapids knows of Zach Johnson, maybe not so much the foundation. Can you tell us a little bit about your role there?
Sure. So I've kind of undergone a transition over the last few weeks. I spent the last 3 years as the site manager at our Van Buren Elementary site. So we have school year programming there, and then students from Van Buren Elementary also can participate in our summer programming called Kids on Course University. And our director, Beth Malecki, wrote a grant for us to get an AmeriCorps program, so I am now becoming our AmeriCorps Program Director. So we will have 10 AmeriCorps members during the school year and 20 during the summer to support our mission.
Can you talk to us a little bit about that mission and exactly what the Zach Johnson Foundation and how it got started?
Sure. So when Zach won the Masters tournament in 2007, he decided, you know, this is a great time to start giving back to the community that raised me. So he created a foundation, built a board of directors to help guide that foundation, and the board started meeting with nonprofit and education leaders here in Cedar Rapids to see what the needs were in the community, and decided to focus on kids and giving kids opportunities that they wouldn't have otherwise had. You know, Zach grew up having golf lessons, you know, doing well in school because his parents really supported his education, and not all kids have that advantage. So he really wanted to give back to the kids and support kids academically and help connect them to passions such as golf, soccer, dance, things like that, that can also support their academic success.
And tell us about the role that Zach plays and his wife Kim play in this foundation.
Yeah, so Zach, you know, he's an amazing guy, and Kim is also just awesome, and they really support our mission in a lot of different ways. You know, Zach earns money, and that helps fund the foundation, but he and Kim also really have a strong vision, and they really are passionate about the foundation and guide us as members of our board of directors.
You talked to us a little bit about Kids on Course. Can you tell
Sure.
us a little bit more about that?
So Kids on Course is the actual program that the foundation runs. We are at 3 elementary schools here in Cedar Rapids and 2 middle schools, and we're rising into high school this coming school year. So a lot of years ago we started with a group of second graders, and we followed those kids every year as they got older, and they're now going into 9th grade. This coming school year we will be serving students from 1st through 9th grade, and we have after school opportunities for them that help build their academic skills. We have family engagement opportunities, and we also, like I said, work to connect them with a passion, such as a sport or an art or something that can really connect them to school.
And there is a tagline. It's dream big. Tell us a little bit about what you dream big for these kids.
Sure. Our big dream is that they do well in school, they're connected to their community, they're doing well socially with friends, and that they do well enough in high school that they can go on to college or some other sort of post-secondary education.
Also, talk to us a little bit about just what's inspiring about the work that you do and some of the successes that you've seen.
Sure. So this summer at our Kids on Course University program, which is a 7-week academic program for students who are behind in reading, we've had some of those 9th grade students volunteering at the camp. And so I've been able to see their growth from second graders, and now they're 9th graders, and they're giving back to the program that helped them. And it's just been really amazing to see their maturity and their attitude of serving and giving back to us. So
talk to us a little bit about what does make the foundation unique and ways that the community can help toward your
Sure.
mission.
So the community can help always by donations, and also by volunteering with us and working in our after-school programs. We have lots of opportunities that you can find on our website for that.
Yeah, where would someone go to learn a little bit more about all the great things you do for the community?
Yeah, so our website is kidsoncoursecr.com, and you can find all sorts of great information on there about our program and opportunities to give back.
Well, it's always a pleasure. Greg, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
This has been Mediacom News Leaders, your opportunity to get the full story from the most reliable sources, exclusively on Mediacom News Leaders.